going to give me a man-child. I'm going to tell my husband Abraham to lie with my maid, Hagar. That's what I'll do. Abraham! Abraham! Abraham, I need you to have sex with my... Abraham, I've come to the conclusion that God is not going to give us a man-child. So you need to have sex with Hagar.
If it pleases you, my love,
just go do it.
Do you blame me? She's got a beard.
Thank you, folks. I hope you like that little illustration. It's probably not far from the truth, knowing the way man, the way we are. Okay. And I'll be making a little video that explains how I'm going to move forward with the Comedian's Guide to the Bible. I hope to get more elaborate, more professional with my stuff. As you can see, it's just me and the camera, and I don't know how to edit, and I don't know how to do none of that stuff, so I'm going to need some folks to help invest a little bit, and maybe you'd like to be part of that. Anyway, let's get on to the Bible study. This is from Genesis 16. Now Sarah, Abraham's wife, had borne him no children, but she had an Egyptian maidservant named Hagar. So she said to Abraham, "The Lord has kept me from having children. Go sleep with my maidservant. Perhaps I can build a family through her." And that illustrates how desperate we all get when we know God's promised us something, but he's taken too long. We jump the gun oftentimes. What's great about that is God was still merciful. He didn't kill that kid. He didn't shame them. He let them know that it was not the right thing to do, especially later on when they saw that Isaac was the son that God had promised. But that's another story. God was merciful, and he even told the maid, "Don't worry, I'm going to bless you." He's a merciful God even when we make mistakes. So, but it does illustrate how impatience can mess us up, okay? So yeah, we get impatient with God and we try to jump the gun. As an illustration of this in my own life, I was still a single man in my late 30s and living for the Lord the best I could. I look back now and I'm thinking, you know, I was kind of backslidden or at least compromising, but mostly out of ignorance. Either way, I was a praying man, I was going to church, and I decided to start helping God in his effort to bring a wife to me. So I went from church to church to church to church, trying to find that woman that God has for me. Okay? You don't have to do that. You just have to put God first, seek first the kingdom of God, and if he has someone for you, I've learned, as many others have, he'll make sure you find each other. Because I found my wife, the love of my life, the desire of my heart, in a way that I never would have imagined. I was living in the Chicago area. I got a gig in a little town called Raytown, Missouri, a suburb of Kansas City. And after the show, this sweet little girl came up and talked to me. And somehow we exchanged numbers and we talked. And she visited a friend in Chicago and we fell in love. And I had to move to Kansas City. And I had no plans whatsoever to do that. And I never would have went to Kansas City, and I definitely wouldn't have went to that little church where I found my wife, but God orchestrated it and made it happen. And let me tell you, there's no woman in the world I want more. He knows me better than I know myself. He knows you better than you know yourself. So if God's given you a promise, whether it's in your career, your finances, your ministry, your family, someone, you know, maybe has strayed from the Lord, I don't know, or maybe like me, you are looking for a spouse, wait upon him. Put him first. Wait upon him. Don't do like Abraham's wife did and try to make it happen on your own, because although God will forgive you, it's going to be a mess. If you read the whole scripture in Genesis 16 and beyond, it became a mess. And to this day, I won't get into it, but to this day, that little kid that didn't come from God's first and best has kind of caused trouble. So trust the Lord. Wait upon him. What do you do while you wait? You don't sit there. I once heard a great preacher say, you got to get moving so you'll know where God wants you to go. So while you're waiting upon the Lord, do all you can with what you have, and don't try to make that promise happen in the flesh. Of course, there's things we need to do. In my career, I study as an actor, I write jokes as a comedian, but I'm not going to go manipulating or whatever people to try to get what I want. I'm not going to do something that I know in my heart is God saying, that's not how I'm going to work. I'm going to wait upon him and trust his timing, okay? So I hope that blesses someone today. And I'm going to do a little video, like I said, that explains my Comedian's Guide to the Bible and my other filmmaking and sketches and stuff, all my aspirations there. And I have a little page during this coronavirus time especially where folks who like my stuff, you can help a little bit. And I got stuff to give you in return. I'm not just asking for people to just give me their bucks. I have stuff for you in return that's going to make it a lot of fun, make it worth your while. So check out the video explaining how I'm going to move forward in my career. And if you feel you want to be a part of it, please do. Thank you very much.